you are a child of the fire God that makes you fire. You are a child of the fire God that makes you fire. Now, looking at the word fire, according to Cambridge Dictionary, it's a material that is in the state of burning, that produces flames, that send out heat and light, and might produce smoke. The part I would like to consider here is that fire is a material that is in the state of burning, that produces flames. That is one. Every fire produces what? Flames. And send out heat. That is number two. And then it brings out what? Light. Hallelujah. Now, Deuteronomy chapter 4, verse 24a. Deuteronomy chapter 4, 24a. It is written, "For the Lord thy God is a devouring fire." For the Lord thy God is a devouring fire. That is the King James Version. Hebrews chapter 12, 29. "For our God is a consuming fire." So these two quotations makes it clear in the biblical perspective that the God that we are serving is a fire God. Hallelujah. The God that we are serving is a fire God. In the book of Deuteronomy, we can see it over there. And in the book of Hebrews, we can also see it over there. So both the Old Testament and the New Testament, there is a confirmation that the God that we are serving is a God of fire. John chapter 1, verse 12. "But to all who believed him and accepted him, he gave the right to become the children of God." The question here is that, what defines the relation between a father and a son? What defines the relation between a father and a son? That is the question I would like to ask. What defines the relation? What really testifies that truly this is the child of this man? This man is the father of this very child. Now, all that we can say is that the genetic properties, the genetic characteristics. We can also talk about the blood of the father, the blood group of the father can also be identified in the child or the son. In short, we can say the DNA. So if the Bible says that when we believe and accept Jesus, we are given the right, then it means in the realms of the spirit, we are changed, we are transformed. We no more belong to any other person but the Almighty God. We become the true children. We become the true sons of the Father in heaven. Now the Bible is saying that this God that we are talking about, this Father that we are talking about, is a God of fire. Now, when our God or our Father is fire, then automatically it means we, the children, are also what? Fire. Hallelujah. We are also what? Fire. Because what is in our Father can also be seen in us. Whatever that is in our Father can also be seen in us. I pray for you this day. May you flame up. May you continue to burn in the mighty name of Jesus. May you continue to burn wherever that you are. May you begin to burn. May you begin to flame up in the name of Jesus. Maybe you have not accepted Christ Jesus as your Lord and personal Savior. I'm beseeching you this very moment that just accept him as your Lord and personal Savior, and you have the right to become the child of the fire God, the child of the fire God. Now, let's look at the book of Daniel, chapter number 3. Bible says that a king lived called Nebuchadnezzar. And then the Bible says that this king built a very strong statue. And then he commanded that all those in the province should come and bow before the statue whenever the trumpet is blown and other instruments. And then the Bible says that there were three guys over there who were Hebrews. They were Jews. They were people who had been taught the word of God right from their infancy. And then they knew about God, that their God is a God of fire. And they knew that the Bible says, according to the laws that were given, that they should not bow or they should not worship any other God. And so they made it straight to the king, that king, we are not going to bow down. Bible says that the king was so furious that he said that, hey, if you don't bow down, I will put you in the fiery furnace. And the Bible says that they said that even if our God do not save us, we are not going to bow. And so the Bible says that the king became very furious and ordered that these guys, that is Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, should be tied up and put into the fiery furnace. And the Bible says that the one who threw them into the hearts of the fire, the Bible says that he got burned. But when they got into the hearts of the fire, they started singing praises to the Lord. Hallelujah. Why were they not burnt? Why were they not affected? Because they were carrying some properties in their father. For their father is the God of fire. And so the fire was already in them. And so the fire in the furnace couldn't harm them. Whenever blood transfusion is done, and then you are already O positive. Beloved, if you are giving O positive blood, it can never harm you. They were having the fire in them because their father in heaven is the God of fire. Hallelujah. And so when they got to the fiery furnace, and when they got in there, the fire couldn't harm them. And the Bible said that the king realized that there's something happening. And so he got up from his chair, and then he asked, were they not afraid that we threw into the fire? But it seems I can see another man. It seems I can see another man who looks like the son of the Most High. Beloved, if you will trust in the Lord God Almighty, you will burn in the realms of the spirit, both physical and spiritual. You will burn, and this flame in you, will burn out every kind of sickness. It will burn out every kind of poverty. It will burn out every kind of barrenness. It will burn out every kind of failure. It will burn out every kind of disappointment. It will burn out every kind of shame and disgrace. And any fire from the enemy can never harm you in the mighty name of Jesus. This very moment, I just want to encourage you to know that indeed there is a God who is a God of fire. And when you trust and believe in him, he will also cause you to be fire. May you fire up wherever that you are. May you continue to burn wherever that you are. May the fire of the Lord be seen in your life in the name of Jesus. From henceforth, the heat in you will wipe out everything that is no good in your life right now in the mighty name of Jesus. And the flames in you will give you light wherever that you tread. May you be a blessing. And may the fire of the Lord keep burning in you strongly. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. God bless you.